it's a team sport. You know, all you need are five players who want to play hard. You can have a pickup game just about anywhere. You know, it's one of the few sports that you can play indoor or you can play outdoor. And it doesn't matter who you saddle up with. It's all about the game.
Man, what does this game mean to you? For some of us, it's a dream.
It's like basketball. Brothers, it's a sport that's grown worldwide. And, the world, I mean, it got me where I am today.
Because of the
parents. It took me all over the world.
They might think basketball is life.
It's going to make me
exactly how I can start.
The man I am. To provide
I was like everybody else.
It means a lot to me.
I was a struggling kid from California.
It's everything
with a hope.
No, I want to
be like this.
I don't
know where I would be. Allen Iverson. Thank the Lord that helped him to do this.
But as I got older, I learned a lot of things that people tried to teach me. Basketball is just a game that you should enjoy. And when my hoop dream wasn't working out, I was one of those that got depressed and wondered where I go. And I was looking for motivation. And I found it. I found it in the people that believe in me, who ask me every day to work them out. People like that, they don't know that. They think that I'm helping them. What they don't know, they inspire me. The fact that I get to teach the life lessons that I had to learn. And I'm happy and grateful because I get to show them the true meaning and what basketball really means and how it can help you and everything that comes with life.
That funny looking guy over there, that's me. My name is Trayvon McNabb, but all my friends call me T-Mac. Right now, I'm currently the basketball team manager for Langston girls basketball team. But in my spare time, I like to help my friends kind of work out. You know, show them a few tricks that I learned over the years. And the people that I'm working out right now is two of my closest friends, DP and Lulu. As you see right here, DP, hey, I love this dude to death because this dude, you know, plays with chip on his shoulder.
It means so much to me, man. Back at home, you gotta find a way out. So Langston found a way out for me. Come up here to work hard and show the world that I can do it as a black young man.
Guy, he doesn't have it all. If you watch him, he has a few things that I hope he can get better at, but as just a heart, he has it already. That dude has a grit like I never seen. You know, that dude, he plays with his heart on the line. So, you know, I'm hoping that he does good because, you know, things didn't work out for him at Arkansas Baptist. So, you know, if things work out, maybe I can see him, you know, in the Langston jersey one day. And who knows, maybe one day, you know, he can play overseas. But as of right now, you know, I'm just trying to, you know, help him to sharpen up a few of his weaknesses because great defender. But I'm hoping that maybe he can become a better ball handler. And with his shooting, he has a nice shot. The only thing is, I want him to just hold the ball differently. But DP, you know, that guy, he has something special. You know, he can be all over the place, but if things work out, you know, I don't see, you know, why he can't go too far. But, you know, I'm going to pray for him, and we'll see what happens with him.
boy tired.
My boy tired.
Hard work, be telling me. Any day.
Mm-hmm.
How you feel after the workout?
Yeah, man, feel very tired. Put a couple shots, did some dribbling drills, you know. Thank the Lord that I had the opportunity to do this, and I thank T-Mac, and I thank Lou, and I thank the cameraman that supporting T-Mac for his project. Thank you. What keep me going here? My nephew, he died at 15 years old, 3 months ago. He got shot 12 times. He got shot in the face. It's all cuffs, all state. In 9th grade, so I feel like I got a monkey on my back. I want my dream to come true. I'm trying to make it. Have God first, school, my family. Thank everybody that motivated me. I want the best for me. And I thank y'all for the glory. Best to the Lord.
I think a lot of us, you know, kind of never got how hard it is to play overseas in the NBA. And that's the thing, too, I think we don't get until we get older. You know, we're so hell-bent on making it, but we actually don't get the realities of playing. You know, and kind of break down everything and what goes wrong a lot of times with us. You know, I got one of my friends who's a coach now at Lincoln University, you know, Trey Hendon, who also was at Oklahoma State University and seen a few guys go overseas in the NBA, you know, kind of tell you the realities of, you know, playing at that level.
I've coached at a lot of levels. This is just another opportunity to coach guys that are just living out their dream of playing college basketball and hoping to further it, but just trying to win a championship. I think it's just something that's easy to love. You know, it's not only just sport, it's fast tempo sport, it's a fun sport to watch, it's a fun sport to play. Not a lot of people just say, let's go play, pick up football or pick up baseball. Everybody plays basketball. It's a sport that's grown worldwide, and we're fortunate to have a bunch of guys that love the sport and love the game and love being coached. So that's made it really fun here at Langston.
Professional.
I mean, I think going from playing high school to playing college and then even professional, I mean, it really becomes a job. I mean, you also have your responsibilities of your personal life and academics, but, you know, we expect these guys to get in here, work out. We expect them to study film. We expect them to focus and practice and even be committed on the road when we're traveling. You know, the teams that you see succeed the most really buy into the life aspect of it. If they want to make it their life, they do things where
people don't honestly understand about the reality of making it overseas in the NBA.
Oh wow, yeah. I know a few guys that have played overseas. I've had the opportunity to coach a few guys overseas, even had a few opportunities to coach guys that played in the league right now, whether it be in All-Star Games or at Oklahoma State University. I think the reality that people have to face is you're not the only one looking for that goal. There's thousands, tens of thousands of players trying to achieve the goal of playing overseas and playing in the league. What are you going to do to stand out from those other people? Are you going to work harder? Are you going to focus more on the academics? Because that's just as important. You got to take care of that to even become a good basketball player. What are you going to do that's going to make yourself stand out? Because at that next level, whether it be overseas or in the league, they're focused on trying to find somebody that's going to make a difference for their program. Same thing in the college aspect. When we're recruiting, we want a guy whose character and whose skill is going to stand out in our program. So I think that's the most important thing about achieving that professional goal is what are you going to do to make yourself stand out? Are you going to work or are you just going to think about it?
How many people are there? Do you think you can go pro? The potential to you?
No, I think we have some guys that definitely have aspirations. I think we have guys that are working for it. We'll see, I think, is a thing. I, you know, I'd love to bring guys here that have that ability and have that skill set to go play overseas, because that means that that we're having guys playing at a high level here at Langston, and I think we have some guys like that right now. Because we're first place in conference right now, and hopefully we'll continue that.
Now, who's that girl over there? That's Lulu. Her real name is Arnisha Lulu Perry, but everybody just called her Lulu. Lulu, man, that girl is one of the best girlfriends I've ever seen. Lulu's one of those, when you just watch her, you're like, man, she has it. I met her last year, her first season at Langston, and Lulu, she's amazing. Things kind of didn't work out for her when she was at La Tech. She had a few things happen, but she made a lot of coming to Langston.
I started playing basketball when I was a little girl. My dad first introduced me to the game, and I fell in love.
What does basketball mean to you?
Basketball means a lot to me. It's everything, because, without it, I don't know where I would be, honestly. Game, free education for one. Free education. And then after that, hopefully playing professional and coaching and impacting young girls or young boys.
And she helped contribute to winning the conference championship. And Lulu definitely is going to play freshman one day. But all I'm hoping is that, Lulu just stays on the right track, because she does that. I don't see why she can't go far, because Lulu has something special. And now Lulu, it's kind of interesting watching her, because Lulu is not, what I love about working out with people like her, it's not really much you have to teach her, because Lulu does something good that a lot of people don't understand about ball handling. She's great at reacting. She doesn't necessarily try to hit you with moves, she just reacts to how you finish sticking her. So because she already knows how to react, all I'm trying to do with Lulu right now, just, give her a couple of moves and a couple of head fakes that I think will help her create space while she's on offense and things like that. But she has it, and I think that she's going to be something special. I'm one of the biggest fans, and I hope everything works out, because Lulu, she has something special. So I don't see why she can't, play professionally. And I tell her all the time, man, just keep your head in the books and just keep doing what the coaches tell you to do. You're going to be fine. Everything's going to work out.
Stay off of the leaves. You're not playing the grass to climb the trees. You can't breathe, let alone you get stung by bees. Lord Jesus, your chest just might freeze up. 13 months old with a lung disease that almost took my life twice, brought me to my knees. A system not designed for you to achieve. Police squeeze, library lies, a teacher deceives. But I rose to the top of my class like Kareem. I like the Lakers in the 80s, so worthy I'm Kareem. Not MTV, but my sweet 16s. Married the mic, I love supreme. I'm clear, was a miracle. The way I wedded the rhythm, spiritual. Looking back at it, a lyrical exorcism. A half of the Afro-American dream. The rap for quarterback for a professional team. I'm still standing. Yeah, I'm still here. I'm still standing. I have
a trigger man. Crack never pedal that. Opposite a jigger man. Double my expectancy. Can you believe it? Look, no bullet wounds, not paraplegic. Still standing like the Pledge of Allegiance. Moves made both emotional and strategic. My heart disintegrated in a million pieces. Listen, that's life. Deal with it. Press reset. Download pain. Write a thesis. Perform for millions. Brazilian visas. Transcontinental indigenous divas that speak multiple languages for unspeakable reasons. And still, there are places that I've never been. Like a Statue of Liberty, my knees will never bend. Except for when I'm speaking to God, it feels like halftime. I'ma reach for the stars. I'm still standing.
Never quits with me, you know. She don't even know it, but a lot of my stuff last year when she came in, you know, kind of took some of my moves from her. So, you know, she inspires me in a way too, you know.
Thanks, Mac. Yes, he is. Been working with him for a month or so. Yeah, get me right.
You feel like you can beat TJ?
Yeah, I could beat T-Mac. This guy actually picked me up on his team and in fourth grade, and I've been going ever since.
What's your...
Yeah, I have a combine coming up, so I'm trying to go professional. Three favorite right now, Russell Westbrook, LeBron James, Stephen Curry.
Female.
Female, myself.
If you wasn't in Langston, where would you be playing?
Where would I be playing? I don't know. I actually transferred, so I don't know where I would be. It's been okay. I've learned a lot at Langston. I matured a lot at Langston, so it's been okay.
What's your
explosion? I like explosions.
What type of training you like?
Dribbling, ball handling, shooting, getting up shots, and whatever T-Mac has planned, that's what I like. Probably, I have two. My high school, we played third round in the playoffs when I scored like 50-some points. And then probably at Louisiana Tech when I was there, I had a lot of rebounds, like 17-some rebounds. So those were big accomplishments for me, my favorite things.
Well, there you have it. You know, I couldn't have did it or said any better than how you seen my two friends do it. You see, there's many lessons to learn, you know, from this game. Because the main thing, if you don't get anything from me, I want you to see, just be positive at the end of the day. Not just about basketball, sports, anything like that, just in life in general, you know. Yeah, things don't always work out like we planned, and we can't control that. But the one thing I will tell you, just control how you feel about things. You know, check your emotions sometimes. And always be positive and just, you know, look at the good and everything. And the main thing, you know, I want you guys to learn, at least if you're going to control something, at least control how hard you work and how hard you go at something you love. Because if you love it, you'll do anything for it. And you'll put in that extra mile. And you go that extra effort, you know, just to achieve and go where you love. So we'll see what happens. And you know, we'll see what happens to all my friends and see where they go from here. But hopefully, all is well. And you know, I wish the best for everybody. So if anything, God bless. You guys have a good one.
Forever, wouldn't be forever. The grain ain't enough, they gotta mix it with the lover. The grind ain't enough, they gotta mix it with the hate. When it's all over, what would I say? Forever in a day. Forever still, worry about you and how you live.